sets.
Hooray for the holidays! Hooray for the holidays!
Hooray! 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 Hooray!
December 24th, families all over will be settling down for Christmas Eve.
They will be singing their Christmas carols, reading their Christmas cards, decorating their Christmas trees,
wrapping their Christmas gifts and placing them into Christmas stockings, which will be hung over Christmas fireplaces, containing Christmas logs, little Christmas flags, and Christmas matches.
Okay. I think we get the message. But we need to know why we do all this.
Al, you're somewhat of an expert on the history of mistletoe.
That's correct, Miss Partnership. Did you know that to begin with, 200 years ago, Druid priests used mistletoe to revere plants? They revered the plant because it appeared to have no roots, yet still remained green throughout the winter.
Like a cursed mouth, the cannons thundered in the south, and with the sound, the carols drowned of peace on earth, goodwill to men.
It was as if an earthquake rent the hearthstones of a continent and made forlorn the household born with peace on earth, goodwill to men. And in despair, I bow my head. There is no peace on earth, I said, for hate is strong, which mocks the song of peace on earth, goodwill to men.
The peal of the bells were loud and deep. God is not there, no doth he sleep. The wrong shall fail, the right prevail.
Mary, do you know that you're
tree was believed by ancient peoples to keep away evil spirits, witches, ghosts, and illnesses. They would hang boughs of such trees along with holly outside doors and windows. But how did the Christmas tree tradition find its way to these shores?
I think you will find that I was responsible for that.
You're not a 16th century German!
Certainly not, although some of my ancestors were. I am Prince Albert. When I married Queen Victoria, I thought it would be a very nice idea for us to have a Christmas tree like the ones we had in Germany. When people saw an etching of our family gathered around the Christmas tree at Windsor Castle in 1848, everyone wanted one. Well, all of the rich people, anyways.
I'm sorry, but wasn't it another famous Victorian, Charles Dickens, who invented Christmas?
Christmas Eve will find you where the love light gleams. I'll be home for Christmas, if only in my dreams.
That's not the only contribution you Americans have made to the more modern Christmas. There is White Christmas and endless repeats of The Wizard of Oz on Christmas Day. But there's another character who's very important to Christmas.
Gee, aren't we great? Who is he?
Here's a clue.
I've got it! Homer Simpson!
No! It's Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer.